Come on, Bill.
Look at all that, dude. Look at all that. Check out this steak. Oh yeah, there we go. I'm going to turn this around so that it will drain it like that. You see, I do have a drain slot right here to get a really thick steak like this kind of cooked nicely. You really have to be able to cover it up. Okay, we're up to 114 degrees internal temperature. So I'm gonna that feels good. The 135 degrees Fahrenheit. So it's going to be a very nice medium rare, maybe even a little bit rare. Not quite sure. But I'm just going to start eating it right here off the grill. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Look at that beauty. There's a nice piece of meat right here. Yeah, it's definitely a very nice medium rare. Mm. Wow, that's good. Mm-hmm. Very nicely cooked. Mm. Wow, that is so delicious. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yep. What do you think, Maggie? Do you like it? Sit, Maggie. Sit. Stay. Stay. Hey, kennel. Stay. Good girl. Mm. Wow. That is so good.
Stay. Maggie, come on. Just kidding. Come on. Just stay. Stop. Mm. That was really delicious. I think I'm going to save the rest of it for breakfast. And even then, I'll probably still take some of it home because that is one big steak. Anyway, I'm looking forward to steak and eggs in the morning. So good.
Good morning. I have some hash browns here. I need to rehydrate. So I'm just going to do it right there in the bag. These hash browns tipping over like that was actually perfect because it's going to allow them to drain off all of that extra moisture. In fact, if I can squeeze some of it out, it'll probably be good. Get our steak out. So I want to kind of render that fat so I can cook with it. My pan's not quite level, but I'm going to use that to my advantage. And I'm going to start my hash browns right in that puddle. We'll have steak flavored hash browns. It's going to be awesome. Just looking at the flame, I can see there's more heat over here. And so if I'm gonna get my hash browns to actually get crispy and brown, I'm gonna have to rotate them over there. So I'm just gonna put on my elk skin gloves And yeah, you can see the flame is all on that side. It's a real nice, mellow heat. And it's gonna be perfect for finishing this up. I think I have enough of that fat rendered off that I can go ahead and start putting my steak on so it can warm up. It's already cooked, it just needs to warm up. We'll set this aside and I'll give it to the dogs little by little. I don't want to give them too much. Wow, look at that. I'm gonna pull the cap off of my little secret spice stash here. And put a little Hakata spice on this steak. Ooh-hoo-hoo. The most beautiful thing about steak and eggs is when you can cook your eggs in the steak fat, then your eggs taste like steak. I'm gonna put a little Hakata spice on my eggs. My fire is burned down to hot coals, so this will be the perfect temperature if I just cover it and let it finish. Stay. No. 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 Okay. Good girl. I really don't want to build up the fire because I like slow cooked, you know, nice tender eggs. Ooh, everything's nice and hot though. Yeah, it's gonna be good. Breakfast is served. Hoo hoo hoo, look at that. Oh, this has got to be one of my top breakfasts. So nice. Build the ultimate bite. A little bit of egg. A little bit of hash brown. Look at that. You like that pack, Bill? No. That's my paleo hiker patch. You can't have it. This is our final version of the kit pack. So I promised you that this panel would go up higher and have snaps. So it has snaps, and we put a little more body in this panel. And so I've got my plate and a cutting board in there. And then we added a little more body to this panel as well, so it would work better as kind of a shelf, kind of as a workstation like that. I'm really happy with it. These gussets are designed to automatically kind of fold inward so they get out of the way for the zipper. Right now I just have my coffee in there,